Hey YouTube, how's it going? Kiefer DeLorm here with Clientric, and in today's tutorial, we are continuing our multi-step process of Zoho CRM. And so just to sum up what we've gone through in the past, we've gone through the home section, the lead section, the contact section, the account section, and the deal section. And I just realized that we forgot to close this negotiation here as one. So let's go ahead and close that as one, and we can close it as the original date of November 18th, 2022, and click Save. And that closes off this deal. So it's ready to be moved on to the next stage. So the next tab will be the Task tab, which is what we'll be going through today. So basically, this is a tab here. So you can either import existing tasks or create a new task. In this case, we are going to create a new task. So our task owner, of course, is me, user one demo. Subject is a, let's do a follow-up email, and the due date will be today. And the contact will be for Jimmy Smith at Pepsi. Status will be not started yet, priority high, and you can turn on reminders here. So this is a really good way, if you're anything forgetful like me, remembering to follow up with your customers is the number one way to, of course, get success in the end. So let's follow up with them on the following Monday, so Saturday, Sunday, Monday. And I find it's easy to do this kind of stuff in the morning. That way you don't get distracted with the rest of the day yet. So let's just do that. So on Monday morning, we're going to send the email and we'll get a notification by email. So click done. We'll set the reminder for Friday. There we go. And you can repeat them too. So if you look, you can repeat it every day until you've completed it, or weekly, monthly, yearly, or you can set custom parameters. Really, really helpful. But in this case, we're not going to need any repeats or reminders. So we'll just keep that off. And description is follow up with Mr. Smith regarding the signing of the invoice, send email regarding next steps and info required from Pepsi to move forward. And that's it. And so we can click save that or save a new if you want to create another one. But you can go in here. So this is your task page. You can see, so this is an email. You can actually create custom tags too. So if you have like specific types of tasks, let's say follow up email in this case, boom, you click that, save. And now, you know, this type of email is a follow-up email. So that can be a good way to just organize your task section in general. So the priority on this one, of course, is high. Due date is the 18th. Status, let's say that we've sent this out now. So we're going to click completed and we're going to mark it as completed. Boom. And you can actually add any follow-up task here if there's another thing required. But in this case, let's say we just sent the email. It's all good. Also, on that note, you can actually send the follow-up email. Boom, click that. Here's your email right here. So you can say, here is the next steps. Hi, Jimmy. Thank you for your business. Wanted to take a quick second to send you a copy of your invoice and share with you the next steps moving forward. And then here you can list what kind of tasks you want to do. Two, stay awesome, Kiefer. And you send that email, and then boom, now your task is completed already. We've already clicked completed in this case, but that is how you go. So you can see your customer information here, deal summary, so that we've obviously won that deal. You can create new tasks, meetings, or calls, and they would show up here. And all of your task-related information is here. So the description that we wrote is already there. Our notes from the past, remember when we did in the contact section, that is here as well. We can add the file. So we'll add that to this folder here, attach, boom, now it's in there. So our invoice is in there as well. So if we ever need to view it, we can actually view it right here. Links is where you can add, for example, like a Zoho work drive. If you're collecting all of your customer information in another area as well, you can add a URL for that as well. And then upcoming actions. So if you have any tasks, meetings, or calls that are going to be coming up soon, this is where that would come up. So for that, that is basically the task section. Not a big section, but very, very powerful tool to be able to keep yourself on track and keep following up with your customers on time. So if you have any questions on this, let me know. Leave a comment. I'm more than happy to help out. Or send me a personal email at my email, kiefer@clientric.co. That'll be in the description. Other than that, I hope you please like, subscribe, and remember to follow. And have a good rest of the day. Stay awesome.